Here we are at the St. Martin's Church. All Canterbury of Roman times. They've laid the foundation for a mission, for a religion to spread a message of good from Jesus Christ, was taken all the way across Europe to England. And this is the continuously living and working church to this day in the English-speaking world. That's the Roman walls just there, built by the monks in the ancient site.
Well read. It can't be the one that Ethelbert was baptised in,
right.
Because it's Norman, which means 1066 and all that.
Yeah.
And Ethelbert was baptised in around 600. Yeah.
Yes.
So it's a little bit out, isn't it? We know that from a letter in 601.
Right.
That congratulates Bertha on her husband's baptism.
Yes, and what about the decorative features?
Sorry.
Decorative features on the outside.
That,
does that,
that
represent?
Decoration is very similar to decoration in the cathedral cloisters,
right.
Because it's thought to have been in Grandpad.
Yes,
and whoever reconstructed it, because it ended up at the front, up the top there, and the front
just
of the
by
room.
The altar. Okay.
Then it. In front of the,
steps.
And then it moved down to here. And somewhere in the moving, whoever reconstructed it hasn't got the circles right.
Okay.
But if you go into the precincts, into the cloisters, you
yes.
will see some little old columns. They have that carving.
Of carving.
And
is that a marble stone? Is it through from this area or sort of the stones?
Most of the stone, I think that's cornerstone, which comes from France.
Oh, okay.
Most of the cathedral is built from France, French stone. And they used to bring it across the water to Fordwich. Do you know where Fordwich is?
Which I have been through, but I haven't actually been to the landing.
As you know, it's only a couple of miles into Canterbury.
Yes.
And they used to give